This is it, guys. Itto has finally been released. So, who is better? AC0 Itto or AC6 Noelle? This time we can compare them directly using real gameplay, and calculate their DPS using real rotation. But before that, we need to understand the basics of Itto's kit first. Like Noelle, Itto will gain a massive attack bonus by casting his burst, based on the amount of defense he has. His attacks will become geo and cannot be overridden by any other elements. Itto will gain superlative super strength stacks by performing normal hit combos or casting his elemental skill. He will gain 1 stack at his 2nd normal attack hit, 2 stacks at his 4th normal attack hit, 1 stack by damaging an enemy with his elemental skill or his bull, 1 more stack when his bull gets hit by an enemy, and 1 last stack when his bull is gone. When he's under his ultimate burst duration, his 1st and 3rd normal attack hits also give him 1 additional stack each. Itto can have a maximum of 5 superlative super strength stacks, and you can see the maximum stacks indicator there. When he charge attacks, he will consume the stacks instead of his stamina, and when he consumed the last stack, he will perform a powerful slash damage. Now it may look complicated, in practice it's actually simple. In the trial run, I've found that his effective rotation actually looks as easy as like this. First, cast his elemental burst. Then elemental skill. Then charge attacks. Then normal attacks. Then followed by another charge attacks. And lastly, cast his elemental skill. That rotation gives you a whopping 4022% of geo damage multiplier in a single burst at talent level 10. But keep in mind that the rotation needed Itto to have at least 4 stacks to begin with. Now for a scenario like the start of an abyss floor, where Itto have no stacks, his effective rotation should look like this. First, cast elemental burst, then elemental skill, then normal attacks, then charge attacks, then another normal attacks, and lastly, cast another elemental skill. This rotation gives you 3825% of geo damage multiplier within a single burst. I found that these rotations are practical and easy to perform, so let's use one of these rotations as the baseline for calculating Itto's DPS. I will use the latter, because I'm assuming that in the start of the Abyss floor, Itto won't have any stacks to begin with. And Abyss is the reason why we're calculating their DPS in the first place. I will also assume that Itto will be supported by a Geo Resonance and a permanent shield, either from Zhongli, Noelle, or any other shielder you like. So after calculating using our DPS calculator, which you can also copy and use by visiting the link in the description below, here are the simulated Itto's damage numbers. You can watch his actual rotation on the left, and look at his simulated damage numbers and DPS on the right.
It's showtime! Attaboy! Let's roll!
Those damage numbers are based on a simulated Itto at level 90, with the Husk of Opulent Dreamset, and R1 Redhorn Stonethreser weapon at level 90. With all talents at level 10, and a baseline substats that I've been using for my other characters' DPS calculation videos to maintain fairness in comparing their DPS. The baseline substats I'm using consists of 20 crit substats across 5 artifacts, so it's a pretty average to decent substats to simulate average person's luck like myself. Now that we know his damage numbers and DPS, let's compare it with a C6 Noelle. With Noelle, I'm gonna use this following rotation as her baseline DPS calculation. First, elemental skill, then elemental burst, then a series of normal attack combos, then swap to her supports in the middle of her burst, and continue the normal attacks until the burst duration ends. And same as Itto, I will show you my Noelle's rotation on the left, and her simulated damage numbers on the right, using the same baseline level, weapon, talents, artifact set, and substats.
I must leave no stone unturned, as a good knight should. Huh?
burst forth.
Rest and rebuild.
Now that's AC6 Noelle's damage numbers and DPS. So this is it, guys. This is the answer that we've been looking for, a direct DPS comparison between AC0 Itto and AC6 Noelle with their current best-in-slot weapon, an R1 Redhorn Stonethreser. Now how about an R5 or R1 Whiteblind? Or an R5 Redhorn? Don't worry, I've got you covered. Here are the DPS results for those weapons. As expected, AC0 Itto has slightly better DPS than AC6 Noelle. But is Itto worth pulling? The answer depends. If you really want a pure Geo main DPS and you don't have AC6 Noelle, then go for it. The amount of DPS a C0 Itto can provide, even with a craftable white blind, is huge. But if you already own AC6 Noelle, I don't think it's worth anything to pull for another similar unit. In fact, it's better to just spend on the weapon banner and get the Redhorn for your Noelle. Noelle with an R1 Redhorn has similar DPS compared to Itto with an R5 Whiteblind. Plus, your Noelle can also heal the entire team and provide a shield to herself, so you can have 3 vacant slots for your sub DPSs, thus boosting the team's total DPS. Next, as always, I will show you the complete weapon DPS comparison chart for both Itto and Noelle. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Also, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on my future DPS comparison videos, and please like the video to help the channel grow. I thank you guys for your continued supports, and I wish you luck on your pulls.